Hello students, good morning. In yesterday's class, that means in previous class, we discussed or we solved the different problems for the shear force and bending moment diagrams for the cantilever beam with the different types of loads, that is point loads, multiple point loads. And also we looked over the UDL. In today's class, we are going to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for the cantilever beam with a uniformly varying load. So look at the problem. A cantilever beam of length 4 meters carries a gradually varying load. Gradually varying load means a uniformly varying load, UVL load, 0 at the free end and 2 kilonewtons per meter at the fixed end. Draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams. This is the problem given. For this problem, we have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams. First, draw the load diagram by the given data. First, draw the cantilever beam with one end is fixed and another end is free. The fixed end is located as A and the free end is located as B. Here the zero at the free end, that means zero at the free end point B, which is gradually increases or low, gradually varying load up to fixed end. That fixed end load is 2 kilonewtons per meter is given in the problem. So this is the gradually varying load or triangular load it is called. After drawing the load diagram, we have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram below the load diagram by drawing the vertical line from fixed and free end. These two diagrams must be below the load diagram. So before going to the draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams, we have to find the shear force and bending moment values at salient points, at different points of the beam. So this is the one of the point of the cantilever beam B, and another fixed end point is capital A. These are the two points. At these two points, we have to find the shear force and bending moment values. So let us take a xx section at a distance of x from the free end. Free end nundi xx distance lo, x distance lo, let us consider a xx section. There we have to find the shear force and bending moment values in terms of x. Then we can substitute that x value from at 0 at B and 4 meters at A. Clear students? First manam cheyalsindi entante, we have to take the xx section at a distance of x. Now find the shear force values at xx and bending moment values at xx. If you want to find the shear force, what is the shear force value at particular point? The shear force value at xx means the shear force, that is the force acting on the right side, total force acting on the right side of the section is called the shear force, summation of all the forces. What is the force contained in the on the beam at the right side of the section? This is the load which is right side of the section. This is the triangle. So what is the load acting on the right side means the area of this triangle, then which that the area of the triangle represents load on the beam on the right side of the xx. So how to find the area of this triangle? What is the triangle formula of into length into, what is the length of this smaller triangle? X, isn't it? Into what is the breadth of this triangle? Breadth of the triangle means from this height, E height. This height, how to find this height from the similar triangles? This is the bigger triangle and this is the smaller triangle. How to find the triangle height? Let us take the height of the smaller triangle as Y, divided by what is the height of the bigger triangle is 2 kilonewtons per meter, that is equal to what is the length of that smaller triangle is x, and what is the length of the bigger triangle which is 4 meters. From this, y is equal to 2x by 4. That means x by 2. Y is equal to x by 2. This is the height of the smaller triangle, which represents the load intensity of the smaller triangle. Clear, students? This is the x by 2 I written here, the height of the triangle. Therefore, we can substitute at this place, then we can calculate the area of this triangle. Area of the triangle is half into length into breadth. Breadth in terms of x is x by 2. Therefore, x square by 4 is the load content on the beam right side of the section, which is represents as fx. Fx is equal to area of the smaller triangle, which is right side of the section. Clear, students? This represents x square by 4 is the shear force at xx. X square by 4 is the shear force at xx. One minute. Yeah, I represents here shear force at xx section is half into x by 2 into x, x square by 4, which is in downward direction. Load is acting on the beam is always downward direction. That's why it is taken as positive. And also shear force varies with respect to x, that is the x square. That means we have to draw the parabolic curve. The shear force diagram is in the form of parabolic curve, because it varies with respect to x square. So let us substitute. If we want the shear force at B, then x plus low 0 substitute here. If we substitute the 0 at x value, then we can get the shear force at B. Here we are taking this xx section. Whenever the x is equal to 0, that means the section considered at P. So whenever the x is equal to 0, we can get the shear force at B. Whenever the x is equal to 4 meters, that is x becomes 4 meters at fixed end. If you substitute the x place 4 in place of x 4, 4 square by 4 is 16 by 4 is 4 itself. So 4 kilonewtons. Shear force at A is 4 kilonewtons. Clear, students? Shear force at free end is 0. Shear force at a fixed end is 4 kilonewtons whenever x is equal to 4 meters in the shear force equation. So first to draw the shear force diagram like this, draw the baseline, draw the vertical lines from A and B from the load diagram, and draw the baseline in between the A and B, locate A and B points, and the shear force at B is 0. And shear force at A is 4 kilonewtons somewhere else on the vertical line from drawn from the A. So how to join the 0 and 4 kilonewtons? Because it is a UVL between the A and B. Whenever the UVL is there between the A and B, the shear force diagram is parabolic curve. Dear students, join 0 and 4 kilonewtons by a parabolic curve. This is the shear force which is in positive side, because 4 kilonewtons is positive shear force. Then coming to the bending moment, if we consider the xx section again for the bending moment diagram, what is the bending moment at xx? We have to write the bending moment at xx. How to write the bending moment at xx? Already we find the load on the right side of the section is s squared by 4. The triangle, area of the triangle represents x square by 4, which is acting on the right side. Where that is x square by 4 force is acting, concentrated at center of gravity of this triangle. This smaller triangle yoka center of gravity ekkada untundo, aa center of gravity daggara ee force concentrate avutundi. So ekkada untundi dan center of gravity, already we learned in the engineering mechanics. What is the distance of center of gravity from the base? The center of gravity from the base is x by 3 because the length or height of the triangle is x out there. It is from the base, the center of gravity is x by 3. From the apex, it is 2x by 3. So what is the bending moment at xx? The force is x by 4. Distance, perpendicular distance is x by 3. Therefore, bending moment at xx is equal to, that is mx is equal to x by 4, that is x square by 4 into x by 3. Clear students? X by 3, total x cube by 12, which is positive or negative? How to know the positive or negative? It is acting downward direction. The downward direction develops the couple or movement about the xx in clockwise direction. So the movement is in clockwise direction. In the right side, the clockwise is taken as negative. Therefore, bending moment is in negative direction. So therefore, x cube by 12 minus x cube by 12. Total bending moment at xx is minus x cube by 12. So bending moment varies along the beam with respect to x cube. With respect to x cube, it is varying. That's why we get the cubic parabolic curve between two points. Clear, students? So mx is equal to how much? Minus x cube by 12. If we want to find the bending moment at B, free end, the x becomes 0. So whenever x is 0, the section at B, and whenever x is equal to 4 meter, x, the section is considered at A. If we consider the section at A, x becomes 4. If we consider the section at B, x becomes 0. So if we substitute the 0 value at x place, then we can get the bending moment at B. Bending moment is B value is 0. Clear, students? If we substitute in place of x 4 meters, minus 4 cube by 12, minus 64 by 12. Clear, students? Yeah, written. Just a minute. It is not changing the slide. So if you substitute the 4 value at place of x, then we can get bending moment at A value. So this is the bending moment at xx section is minus x square by 4 into x by 3 distance, that is x cube minus x cube by 12 is the bending moment. Clear, students? So if you substitute the 0 value, we can get the bending moment at B. And if you substitute the in place of x cube but the 4 cube by 12, that is 64 by 12, that means minus 16 by 3, minus 5.33 kilonewton meter. Bending moment means kilonewton meter. And the shear force is kilonewtons. It is the force units. Moment unit is force into distance kabati kilonewton meter rostra. So it is minus value 5.33 at the A point, bending moment at A. So first of all, draw the baseline in below the shear force diagram. Locate the point A and B. Then 0 at the bending moment at point B is 0, and bending moment at A is 5.33 kilonewton meter towards the negative side of the baseline. Clear, students? Here we're getting minus 5.33. Note chalsindi matram 5.33. Endukante baseline kinda ne note chesukon kabatti that automatically that represents negative bending moment. Clear, students? So how to join 0 and 5.33? It is cubic parabolic curve. It is cubic parabolic curve. Join 0 and 5.33 by a cubic parabolic curve. Cubic parabolic curve having more curvature than the parabolic curve, because here 4 kilonewtons, here 5.33 kilonewtons, the curvature is more. Clear, students? After joining the 0 and 5.33, it is close to the A. Close the curve and hatch all the sections and represents negative bending moment, minus sign in at the center of the bending moment diagram. Like this, we have to draw the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram for the cantilever beam with UVL value. Clear students, Ardhamainda? Simple. This chapter is very simple. First of all, shear force and bending moment equation you have to write in place in terms of x and substitute the values of x at the extreme point of the beam. Then we can get the shear force and bending moment values. By knowing the values of shear force and bending moment, then we can locate the dirt values below or above the baseline, and by joining those values we can get the shear force and bending moment diagrams. Clear students, this is the one of the problem. Up to now we discuss the shear force and bending moment diagrams for the cantilever beam. Then we have to find the shear force and bending moment diagram for simply supported. So next, shear force SF and BM diagrams for a SSB. SSB means simply supported beam. Simply supported beam with a point load at midpoint. So in this problem, we have to draw the shear force and the bending moment diagrams for a simply supported beam. So what is mean by a simply supported beam? We have three types of statically determinant beams. One is the cantilever beam, second one is simply supported beam, third one is overhanging beam. Here simply supported beam is given. Simply supported beam means the beam which is supporting or resting on two supports at ends of the beam. Clear students, oka beam ends point daggara support cheyabadi unte danni simply supported beam antam. Simply supported beam paina what type of load is acting? A point load or concentrated load acting at the center of the beam. So first of all, draw the load diagram. This is the load diagram. What is the load diagram? First to draw the horizontal beam, locate two points at the ends, and at two points we have to draw the arrow marks in the upward direction. Those are the reactions at the supports. RA, RB are the reaction forces or reactive forces, and locate the midpoint or center point of the beam as C. At that center point, draw a arrow mark downward direction which represents the load, point load capital W. Like this, first of all you have to draw the load diagram. Then after that, to analyze this problem for the shear force and bending moment diagrams, we have to take the section x section at a distance of x from the right support. Here the left support is A, right support is B. We following the right hand side rule, that's why I'm taking the distance from the right support. In this problem, first of all you have to find the reactive forces. No need to find the reactive forces in the cantilever beam, but in simply supported beam, before proceeding to the problem, first of all you have to find the reactions or reactive forces at the supports. By symmetry here we say that the reaction force RA is W by 2 and RB is W by 2 because the load W is acting at the center. Therefore, the support A is and support B are sharing the reaction forces equally, which is equal to half of the load applied on the beam. Clear students, that's why I written here RA equal to W by 2, RB equal to W by 2. Otherwise, if we W is not acting at the center, somewhere else, then we have to find the RA, RB value by equation, by using equilibrium equation. How to find the reaction forces? First of all, equilibrium equation sigma Fy is equal to 0. Take sigma Fy is equal to zero, one of the equilibrium equation. Here, why I am taking the y value, y not x, because the reactions and loads are acting in y direction only. By taking this equilibrium equation, Ra, Rb are upward direction. Ra plus Rb are the upward direction. Ra plus Rb must be equal to the total load applying on the beam. This is the one of the equation. Let us take this equation one. Then take the another equilibrium equation. Sigma m a is equal to zero. That means take the moment at A and equal to zero. Sigma m a equal to zero is the another moment equilibrium equation. If we take the moment at this point, what is the moment of Rb with respect to A? Rb into total distance L. If total length of the beam is L, Rb into L is the moment in clockwise, anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise is positive. Minus W is also there on the right side. W into how much distance? It is L by 2, because W is acting at the midpoint of the beam. Therefore, you can take the from distance A to C is L by 2. So W into L by 2. W L by 2 is the moment, which is in which direction? It develops the clockwise moment. It develops in the clock anti-clockwise moment. Therefore, equate this equation as zero. If we equate the zero, Rb will get LL cancel, W by 2 we get. We will get the reaction forces of Rb is W by 2. So by substituting this Rb value in the first equation, if you substitute in place of Rb, W by 2, then Ra equal to W minus W by 2, W by 2 itself. So Ra value kuda W by 2. Here, like this, we have to find the reaction forces. If it is not symmetry, if it is symmetry, generally we can take equal forces, equal reaction forces, W by 2, W by 2. Some of the calculations can be avoided by taking equal forces if it is symmetry. Dear students, then after finding the Ra, Rb values, consider a section xx at a distance of x in between the portion BC, that is in between the points BC. So consider the portion BC. By considering the xx section at a distance of x, then we can write, we have to write the shear force value at xx and bending moment values at xx. Let us go for the first shear force. For the shear force diagram, we have to find the shear force values at B and C. To find the shear force values at B and C, write the equation for shear force at xx. So how to write the shear force at xx? Here I am explaining the shear force. What is the shear force at xx? Let us take the fx is the shear force. So shear force means the forces, algebraic summation of all the forces on the right side of the section. The right side of the section, what are the forces involved? Only Rb is there. Rb, the two upward direction. Therefore, minus Rb, that is minus W by 2. Upward forces are negative in the right side direction. So shear force how much? Minus W by 2 at xx. So here W by 2, here also minus W by 2, here also minus W by 2, here also minus W by 2. Every way, the shear force is constant in between B and C because it is not varying along the beam. It is constant value. That's why, first of all, draw the baseline of the shear force. A, C and B, locate the points. A, B are the extreme points and C is the middle point. From B, what is the shear force at B? Which is minus W by 2. Towards the base, negative side of the baseline, locate the W by 2. So from point B to C, it is horizontal line because the W by minus W by 2 is constant in between the B and C. So minus C dagara kuda minus W by 2 a bending moment. Clear students? Manam PC portion consider chestunnappudu B nundi C variki W by 2 a minus W by 2 a, which is constant, which is not vary with respect to x ఎందుకంటే ఇక్కడ x అనేది లేదు కాబట్టి విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు x ఇది వేరియబుల్ కాన్స్టెంట్ గా ఉంటుంది సో ఆల్్రెడీ మనం టేబుల్ లో నేర్చుకున్నాం ఏం నేర్చుకున్నాం టేబుల్ లో ఇక్కడ లో లేకపోతే షియర్ ఫోర్స్ డయాగ్రమ్ హారిజంటల్ లైన్ డ్రా చేయాలి ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ బి అండ్ సి క్లియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ ద ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ ద ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ టు ఫైండ్ ద షియర్ ఫోర్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఎ అండ్ సి Again, consider again another section x1, x1 at a distance of x1 from the right hand, the right support. So, what is the shear force at x1, x1? Let us take Fx1. Fx1 means the shear force at x, x1, x1. Here, shear force find chayali and then right side lo unna forces ani consider chayali. Then right side lo unna forces enti. What are the forces involved? W in downward direction equals to minus W by 2 is in upward direction or B. So therefore, it is positive W by 2. W by 2. This is also constant throughout the beam in between A and C because it does not vary with respect to x1. So W by 2 at point C, W by 2 at point A. So after that, at point C, locate the W by 2 in positive and positive direction. This is the W by 2. Okay, and which is constant throughout the beam in between the A and C. Ikkada kuda shear force W by 2A. Then it is close to and joined with A point. So minus W by 2, horizontal line, which is suddenly varies up to W by 2 because here. The load is acting point load. Whenever the point load acts, the shear force suddenly varies, and it is varies from minus W by 2 to W by 2, and remain constant between A and C, and then join to with A. This is the shear force diagram. This is the sum of the half of the beam has positive shear force. Half of the beam has negative shear force, negative side. Like this, you have to hatch. ఈ విధంగా హ్యాచ్ చేసుకోండి దీన్ని షియర్ ఫోర్స్ డయాగ్రామ్ అంటాం Dear students, like this, you have to draw the shear force. What is the shear force at point C means? It's having two values. Before considering the W, it is minus W by 2. After considering the W, it is W by 2. What is the shear force at point B? It is minus W by 2. What is the shear force at point A? W by 2. Like that, we have to find the shear force at any section. Shear force, manam find cheskochu. Dear students, coming to the bending moment diagram, let us look the equation I derived. Just a minute, it is not changing the slide again. In the same way, we have to derive the bending moment equation by taking the section xx between C and B and by taking the section x1, x1 between A and C. So I written here shear force at xx section minus W by 2 horizontal and shear force at x1, x1 section is minus W by 2 plus W that is equal to W by 2 cos 2, it is also horizontal. Shear force between B and C is minus W by 2. Shear force between A and C is W by 2. Clear students? Then coming to the bending moment at XX, bending moment X1, X1, manam raasukovali. Let us take the bending moment at XX. Bending moment at XX and ante, bending moment ante, algebraic summation of all the moments of the forces on the right side of the section. సో ఇక్కడ ఎన్ని ఫోర్సెస్ ఉన్నాయి ఓన్లీ రైట్ సైడ్ లో ఎక్స్ఎక్స్ కి రైట్ సైడ్ లో ఓన్లీ వన్ ఫోర్స్ ఇస్ దేర్ దట్ ఈస్ రియాక్షన్ ఫోర్స్ డబ్ల్యూ బై టూ ఆర్బి సో ఆర్బి మూమెంట్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు ఎక్స్ఎక్స్ హౌ టు ఫైండ్ ద ఫోర్స్ ఇంటూ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ డబ్ల్యూ బై టూ ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ ఇన్ విచ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైజ్ డైరెక్షన్ ద యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైజ్ డైరెక్షన్ మూమెంట్ ఈస్ నెగటివ్ క్లియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ So W by 2 into X is the shear force at XX So bending moment at x-axis section is W by 2 into x, isn't it? W by 2 into x is it in anti-clockwise direction. The bending moment diagram varies with respect to x linearly. ఎందుకని ఇక్కడ x వచ్చింది కాబట్టి లీనియర్ గా వేరీ అవుతుంది. x స్క్వేర్ వస్తే పారాబోలికల్ గా, x క్యూబ్ వస్తే క్యూబిక్ పారాబోలికల్ గా వేరీ అవుతుంది. x లేకపోతే అది హారిజంటల్, x ఉంటే ఇన్క్లైన్ లై. ఇక్కడ x లేదు కాబట్టి w మైనస్ w బై 2 w బై 2 అని వచ్చింది కాబట్టి షియర్ ఫోర్స్ అది హారిజంటల్ లైన్ గా డ్రా చేసుకుంటాం. సో x వస్తే లీనియర్ గా వేరీ అవుతున్నట్టు, అంటే x వేరీ అవుతుంటే బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ కూడా వేరీ అవుతుంది. సో బై సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ అయితే x ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0, x is equal to 0 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేశాం అనుకోండి ఈక్వేషన్ లో, ఇక్కడ సెక్షన్ ఇక్కడ కన్సిడర్ చేస్తున్నాడు. సో ఇక్కడ షియర్ ఫోర్స్ బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఎంత అంటే, ఇఫ్ యూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ ది x ప్లేస్ లో 0 దెన్ బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఎట్ బి ఇస్ బికమ్స్ 0. ఇక్కడ 0 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే టోటల్ 0 అయిపోతుంది. ఇఫ్ యూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ x is equal to l by 2, l by 2 అంటే సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ ద బీమ్ దగ్గర, l by 2 అంటే సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ ద beam. So if you substitute at a place of x space lo l by 2 substitute chesam ankonde, at x place lo l by 2 w by 2 into l by 2 w l by 4 avutundi, w l by 4 at x is equal to l by 2. So bending moment at c is w l by 4. Ikkada zero value, draw the baseline first of all, a c b baseline. At point b the bending moment is zero. At point C, bending moment is WL by 4. WL by 4. Okay. Let us consider bending moment at x1, x1. Similarly, x1, x1 in section A madhyalo consider cheyali the portion AC. Ante between AC madhyalo x1, x1 section ni consider cheyali. Adi enta distance lo x1 anukuntunnu. X1 is the distance. Enduku rendu section lu consider cheyali ante, this section is not applicable beyond the point C. ikkada section xx consider chesam kada, it is between B and C a applicable. It is not applicable between A and C because suddenly the load is applying beyond the C. A point load apply avutundi kabatti ikkada teesukunna section between B and C madhyalo teesukunna section ee C daatin tarvata applicable kaadu. That's why we have to take another section x1 x1 at a distance of x1 from the right support, then we can write the bending moment again. So bending moment at x1 x1 means mx1, here I am writing a bending moment equation, mx1 is equal to, how to write the bending moment, ikkada manam consider chestunnappudu din right side unna forces and yokka moments calculate cheyali. So let us take the rb w by 2. W by 2 is the force which is at a distance of, ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ లో ఉంది B నుండి x1 x1 కి, x1 అని కన్సిడర్ చేస్తున్నాం W by 2 into x1. ఏ డైరెక్షన్ లో ఉంటుంది ఇది, యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైస్ డైరెక్షన్ లో, దెర్ఫోర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ పాజిటివ్. ఓకే, దెన్ బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ అబౌట్ x1 x1, మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ అంటే W ఇస్ ద ఫోర్స్ ఇంటూ ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ లో ఉంటుంది అది, ఇక్కడ నుండి ఇక్కడికి ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటుంది, ఇది మొత్తం ఎంత x1, ఈ డిస్టెన్స్ ఎంత ఇక్కడ నుండి ఇక్కడ వరకు l బై 2. సో x1 మైనస్ l బై 2 తీసుకుంటాం, x1 మైనస్ l బై 2, అర్థమవుతుందా? దిస్ ఇస్ ద డిస్టెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ w అండ్ x1 x1. ఇది పాజిటివ్ నెగటివ్ ఆ, ఇది ఏ డైరెక్షన్ లో మూమెంట్ డెవలప్ చేస్తుంది, క్లాక్ వైజ్ డైరెక్షన్, క్లాక్ వైజ్ కాబట్టి నెగటివ్. లైక్ దిస్ యూ హావ్ టు రైట్ ద ఈక్వేషన్స్. ఇప్పుడు ఈ ఈక్వేషన్ లో x1 అనేది ఎంత సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ సి దగ్గర వస్తుంది, x1 బికమ్స్ l బై 2, అంటే ఇక్కడ x1 అనేది l బై 2, x1 ప్లస్ l బై 2 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేసాం అనుకోండి, ఇక్కడ l బై 2 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే ఏమవుతుంది, ఇది 0 అవుతుంది, l బై 2 మైనస్ l బై 2. సో ఇది ఒకటే మిగులుతుంది మనకి, w l బై 2 అంటే l బై 4, w l బై 4 అవుతుంది, అంటే సి దగ్గర బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఎంత, w l బై 4 ఈ సేమ్ యాజ్ ఇందాక క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసిన వాల్యూ వస్తుంది. క్లియర్, ఇది క్వశ్చన్. నెక్స్ట్ అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది, ఎంసి అవుతుంది, బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఎట్ సి పాయింట్ అవుతుంది, ఎక్స్ ఎక్స్ వన్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎల్ బై టూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తాయి. సో దెన్ బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఎట్ ఏ, ఎంఏ, ఎంఏ కావాలంటే ఎక్స్ వన్ ప్లేస్ లో సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేయాలి, ఎక్స్ వన్ ప్లేస్ లో ఇక్కడ నుండి ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ లో ఎల్ ఉంది, ఏ ఉంది, ఎల్ డిస్టెన్స్ లో. సో ఎక్స్ ఎక్స్ వన్ ప్లేస్ లో ఎల్ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేసాం అనుకో, first parameter WL by 2 x plus lo L aithe minus x plus lo L by L by L by sorry L substitute chesam ankonde L minus L by 2 L by 2 so WL by 2 enta bending moment at A WL by 2 WL by 2 cancel aipoyi enta ostundi bending moment at A 0 so bending moment at A is 0 so bending moment at C is WL by 4 bending moment at A is 0 like that we have to calculate the bending moment values after calculating the bending moment values draw the baseline draw cheskondi bending moment ki locate the A C and B what is the bending moment at B 0 what is bending moment at C WL by 4 what is the bending moment at C A 0 it is positive side WL by 4 so 0 WL by 4 0 ela join chestaru ikkada load ledhu kabatti ee rendu madhyalo load ledhu kabatti bending moment anedi linear ga vary avutundi adi equation chusina manaku telisipothundi ela vary avutundi anedi in terms of x lo vastundi bending moment equation just a minute so after locating the bending moment values 0 wl by 4 and 0 join those points by a straight inclined line clear students after drawing the straight inclined lines we get a triangle the bending moment at x1 x1 is w by 2 x1 minus w into x1 minus l by 2 w by 2 W L by 2 minus W X 1 by 2. Simplify chest there. Bending moment at C is X 1 place lo L by 2 substitute chest the W L by 4 ostundi. Bending moment A is 0 whenever X 1 equal to L substitute chest the bending moment at A is 0. Clear students? So if bending moment ela vary avutundi with respect to X 1 vary avutundi kabatti X 1 square ledhu kabatti X 1 e undi kabatti linear ga vary avutu untundi. Aa vidhanga linearly varying line draw chestuntam ee join chesi so locate the plus marks plus mark between the bending moment diagram and draw the bending moment diagram like this it look like a triangle it looks like a two rectangles one rectangle is in negative side and another rectangle is positive side that means shear force is positive shear force is negative between B and C and between A and B is positive between A and C is positive and bending moment is totally from A to B is positive bending moment okay students this is the shear force bending moment diagram for a simply supported beam let us go for another problem shear force bending moment diagrams for a simply supported beam SSB simply supported beam carrying a UDL what is mean by a UDL uniformly distributed load are you understanding this are you following students first of all follow what I am saying then you have to practice again in the notebook by drawing the load diagram by drawing the shear force values and or know the shear force values and by drawing the bending moment diagrams before drawing the shear force and bending moment diagrams you have to find the shear force and bending moment values at different points of the beam then only you can draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams let us see the next example a simply supported beam carrying a UDL here I am not giving any numerical values simply I am taking the UDL value as small w and length of the beam as capital L. Clear students? First to draw the simply supported beam. Simply supported ante oka horizontal beam draw chesukondi which is located on the two supports, two reaction supports. These are the reaction force Ra, Rb at end points. Ra, Rb are the reaction forces by applying the load on the beam this UDL like this ila draw chesukochu inke vidhanga draw cheyochu already I told you If the simply supported beam is like this, beam ila undi anukondi, simply supported beam ikkada UDL ee vidhanga kuda draw chesukochu. UDL rectangular load antam deniki. Another name is rectangular load. So you have to draw a either this in this shape or in this shape. You can draw both types of shape. Okay, like this you have to draw the shear force. First of all, draw the shear load diagram like this. After drawing the load diagram, you have to find the first of all RA and RB. How to find the RA and RB? These are the reactive forces by applying the UDL value. So how to find? By taking the equilibrium equations. What are the equilibrium equations? So if we take the sigma Fy is equal to 0, for the simply supported beam, we have to find the reactive forces first of all by taking the equilibrium equations. So first equilibrium equation, sigma Fy equal to 0. If we take this equilibrium equation, RA, RB values are, RA, RB reactive forces are in upward direction. That's why summation of the upward forces must be equal to the downward forces. What are the downward forces here? One UDL value is there, uniformly distributed load is there, small w, which is acting per unit length, meter, per unit meter. So total value ఎంత అవుతుంది అంటే ఒక మీటర్ కి w అవుతే total length ఎంత మనకి length is l, capital L. This is the total load acting on the beam. Small w into l is the load. Dear students, if you know the UDL value, then multiply the distance, then we can get the load value. So RA plus RB is equal to WL. This is the equation one. Then by taking the movement at certain point, either A or B, if we take the movement at A, sigma MA is equal to 0. This is another equilibrium equation. If we take this equilibrium equation, sigma ma equal to 0, sigma ma ante ikkada mana movement teesukuntunna, ikkada movement teesukunnappudu deeniki remaining forces em unnai, ikkada rb undi, ikkada udl undi. Ee udl ekkada act avutundi? At the cg of the rectangular load, center. Idi mottham ekkada concentrate avutundi ante center of gravity daggara concentrate avutundi. Center of gravity entha distance lo untundi oka end nundi? Total distance l avute, it is L by 2 distance. Okay, so bending moment raaskunnam ankonde, moment raaskunnam ankonde a daggara rb into, ikkada raastunnanu rb into enta rayali, rb into ikkada moment teeskuntunnam, rb enta distance lo undi a nundi? L distance lo undi. Rb into L, it is in a direction lo, it is in clockwise, anti clockwise. Anti clockwise direction, positive or negative? Positive. Then e load enta, e total UDL value enta, inda ga rasam total load, small w into l is the load. Small w is the UDL value multiplied by distance esthe manaki total load on the beam vastundi. Aa total load cg daggara concentrate avutundi kabatti adi cg daggara teeskunte l by 2 avutundi. Now it is in which direction about point A? It is a clockwise. Clockwise direction is negative. WL is the load. WL is the W load kaadu ikkada, WL is the load. W anedi UDL per unit length. Manaki total distance L telusu kabatti WL is the total load into distance enta? L by 2 vastundi. Ekkada nundi ekkadiki distance idi? Load ki mana movement teeskune point ki. Clockwise kaabatti negative teeskundi. This is equal to 0 chestundi. This is the movement about point A. From this L okati cancel ayipi RB value enta vastundi? RB is equal to, okay, L cancel చేశాం అనుకోండి, okay, L common this equal to 0 by something 0 అవుతుంది కాబట్టి RB is equal to ఎంత అవుతుంది? ఇది తీసుకెళ్తే పాజిటివ్ అవుతుంది, WL by 2 అవుతుంది. ఆ W కూడా స్మాల్ W రాయాలి, క్యాపిటల్ W రాయకూడదు. స్మాల్ W అంటే UDL, క్యాపిటల్ W అంటే పాయింట్ లోడ్. సో స్మాల్ WL by 2 is the RB value. మొత్తం ఎంత? WL. WL RA plus RB equal to WL. Therefore RA becomes, RA ఎంత అవుతుంది? By symmetry it can be write as WL by 2. Okay, WL by 2, another kuda WL by 2 rendu add chesthe WL vastundi. Like this you have to find the reactive forces at the end of the beam. Ardhamainda? Ee vidhanga manam reaction find chestunnam. Ikkada already nenu find chestunnanu ee equation lo just a minute. Like this you have to shear force equation rasukoni reaction forces find chesukoni let us take xx section at a distance of x again from the right support. Reaction find chesukuna tarvata xx section nundi xx section anedi x distance lo consider chestam. Ikka chudandi, let a section xx at a distance x from the b nundi x distance lo xx section consider chesukoni ikkada shear force bending moment values raaskuntam. Shear force bending moment equations enti? Shear force at xx is shear force antante deeniki right side lo unna forces ani consider chestam. Right side lo unna forces enti? Ikkada oka rb undi, ikkada udl value right side. Enta distance undi udl? X distance. RB value ఎంత ఇందాక ఫైండ్ చేసింది WL by 2. RB is a WL by 2. So upward direction లో ఉంది ఇది. So what is the shear force at this point? RB minus RB. Minus RB ఎందుకు ఇది upward direction లో minus కాబట్టి minus RB plus WX ఏంటి ఇదేమో UDL value W ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ ఆక్యుపై చేస్తుంది ఇది X డిస్టెన్స్ WX is the total load which is in downward direction. Downward direction లో యాక్ట్ అవుతుంది కాబట్టి so total shear force at xx is this value rb value minus wl by 2 rb value wl by 2 kaabatti replace chesanu reaction forces minus wl by 2 plus wx it is also varying with respect to x linearly ikkada linear anu rasanu x tho vary avutundi. Now how to find the shear force? It is the shear force equation at xx. So if we shear force values ela find chestam? If we want the shear force at b, x value anta substitute cheyali, x is equal to 0. If the x is equal to 0, then we can get the shear force at b. If x is equal to l, x l substitute chesam ankonde naku shear force enta ekkada vastundi, a daggara vachestundi. So if x is equal to 0 in this equation, x 0 substitute chesthe parameter 0, then we can get the minus wl by 2 value is the shear force at b, minus wl by 2. If x is equal to l by l substitute chesam anukondi x plus l wl minus wl by 2 wl by 2 positive idi negative shear force idi positive shear force. Shear force at a is wl by 2. So first to draw the baseline ab, locate the c at the center, then what is the shear force at b? Shear force at b is minus wl by 2. Ikkada nundi minus side wl by 2 locate cheyali. Okay, what is the shear force at A? WL by 2 positive side locate cheyandi because WL by 2 anedi positive shear force at A. Positive side WL by 2 ante ikka nundi enta distance untundo ikka nundi kuda ante distance untundi. Numerical values aithe ikkada manaki WL by 2 WL by 2 kabatti equal distance lo locate cheskondi. Locate chesi ee rendu ela join cheyali linear ga vary avutu untundi with respect to x. So ee vidhanga ee rendu values ni జాయిన్ చేయండి. జాయిన్ చేసినప్పుడు ఈ లైన్ బేస్ లైన్ ఎక్కడ ఇంటర్సెక్ట్ అవుతుంది? సెంటర్ లో, ఎగ్జాక్ట్ గా సెంటర్ లో ఇంటర్సెక్ట్ అవుతుంది. దట్ మీన్స్ సెంటర్ లో జీరో షియర్ ఫోర్స్ ఉన్నట్టు. ఓకే, ఇది జీరో షియర్ ఫోర్స్. సి దగ్గర షియర్ ఫోర్స్ ఎంత? జీరో, బికాస్ ద షియర్ ఫోర్స్ డయాగ్రామ్ చేంజెస్ సైన్ ఫ్రమ్ నెగటివ్ టు పాజిటివ్. ఎక్కడైతే నెగటివ్ నుండి పాజిటివ్ కి చేంజ్ అవుతుందో షియర్ ఫోర్స్, అక్కడ జీరో షియర్ ఫోర్స్ ఉంటుంది. Like this you have to draw the shear force diagram. ఈ రెండు జాయిన్ చేసి ఈ పాయింట్ ని a కి ఈ పాయింట్ ని b కి జాయిన్ చేసి మధ్యలో హ్యాచింగ్ చేయండి. ఇది పాజిటివ్ షియర్ ఫోర్స్, ఇది నెగటివ్ షియర్ ఫోర్స్, ఇది మైనస్ ప్లస్ ప్లేస్ చేయండి. ఈ విధంగా షియర్ ఫోర్స్ డయాగ్రామ్ డ్రా చేసుకుంటాం. Dear students, in the same way we have to find the bending moment at xx. After finding the bending moment equation at xx, then we can find the values of bending moment values at extreme points. Dear students, let us go for the next slide. Bending moment at xx. is bending moment ela find chestam x axis dagara bending moment find cheyalante movement of all the forces on the right side teeskunta so ikkada forces em unnai ikkada oka rb undi ikkada load undi dear students the movement of rb with respect to x axis rb into distance rb into x rb into x a direction lo idi anti clockwise direction positive so rb into x positive next ikkada load undi ee load value entha w is the permeator x distance occupy chesthe motu wx teeskunta aa wx ekkada concentrate avutundi madhyalo so ikkada nundi x by 2 distance dear students wx into x by 2 anustu wx into x by 2 is wx square by 2 adhe direction lo untundi ante ide direction lo untundi ikkada act aina force a direction lo movement develop chestundi clockwise and vala negative so minus wx square by 2 so rb into x minus wx square by 2 is the total bending moment equation at xx which is varies with respect to x square kabatti parabolical ga vary avutu untundi if you substitute the b at x is equal to 0 x 0 substitute chesthe bending moment b daggara vachestundi x is equal to l substitute chesthe bending moment a daggara vachestundi ee equation lo x place lo 0 substitute chesam anko idi 0 ne idi 0 therefore bending moment at b is 0 if you substitute the bending moment if you substitute the x is equal to l then we can get the bending moment at a x place lo l substitute chesam anko wl square by 2 minus ikkada l substitute chesthe wl square by 2 wl square by 2 minus wl square by 2 0 again bending moment at a is also 0 whenever x is equal to 0 so ikkada 0 ne bending moment ikkada kuda 0 somewhere in between these two points the maximum bending moment occurs maximum bending moment is how to get the maximum bending moment wherever the shear force is 0 I already told at the previous classes wherever the shear force is 0 the bending moment becomes maximum okay how to get that maximum bending moment value so how to get the minimum value if we substitute the x is equal to l by 2 ఇది ఎక్కడ 0 అవుతుంది l by 2 దగ్గర 0 అవుతుంది అంటే మిడిల్ లో ఈ మిడిల్ లో 0 అవుతుంది కాబట్టి x is equal to l by 2 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేశాం అనుకో బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఈక్వేషన్ లో దెన్ వి కెన్ గెట్ ద బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ఎట్ సెంటర్ ఇఫ్ యు సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ x is equal to l by 2 ఇక్కడ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే l by 2 wl square by 4 అవుతుంది ఇక్కడ l by 2 సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే wl square by 8 అవుతుంది సో wl square by 4 minus wl square by 8 is wl square by 8 is the value so ee value ekkada c point daggara at the center of the beam daggara bending moment value is idi maximum bending moment so like that we have to locate the wl square by 8 somewhere at point c c daggara nundi positive side ga wl square by 2 locate cheyandi ee mood points ni ela join cheyali idi 0 idi wl square by 8 idi 0 so how to join these three points parabolical ga vary avutundi because the equation is varies with respect to x square x square తో వేరీ అవుతుంది పారాబొలిక్ కర్వ్ డ్రా చేయాల్సి ఉంటుంది సో ఇవన్నిటిని కలుపుతూ ఒక పారాబొలిక్ కర్వ్ డ్రా చేయండి మాక్సిమం పాయింట్ ఇస్ ఎట్ సెంటర్ wl square by 8 దట్ ఇస్ ద మాక్సిమం బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ దట్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో పాజిటివ్ బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ ప్లస్ మార్క్స్ నోట్ చేయండి సో ఈ విధంగా బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ డయాగ్రమ్ ని డ్రా చేసుకుంటాం క్లియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ షియర్ ఫోర్స్ బెండింగ్ మూమెంట్ డయాగ్రమ్ ఫర్ సింప్లీ సపోర్టెడ్ బీమ్ క్యారీయింగ్ ఏ UDL అప్ టు నౌ This class is, I am closing this class.